Cincinnati Bengals taking on Justin Herbert and the LA Chargers.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, and there you get a look at Paul Brown Stadium on the banks of the Ohio River in Cincinnati. The enthusiasm of this Cincinnati crowd in full effect a moment ago as their Bengals took the field to the delight of this sold-out crowd. And they're all set as they'll match up with the Los Angeles Chargers. And about ready to get this going as we are underway now from Paul Brown Stadium. Here's the all-pro returner from 2018, Andre Roberts, and able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Here are the Chargers ready to go on offense, led by their first-round pick in 2020, the man out of Oregon, Justin Herbert.
And he is just absolutely marvelous to watch throw a football. That's something I could do all day long, watch him throw routes versus air. But he's even more impressive when there are bodies on the field and he's creating with big throws downfield.
First down, Justin Herbert. Over the middle, it's Jared Cook.
The coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
A good gain on first has him set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29. They'll run for the first time with Austin Ekeler. And that is not going to get it done either. Once again, he stopped behind the line by this Bengals D. It's a loss of two, now third down.
I thought he did a nice job there setting an edge and make sure nothing could get to the outside. But he decided that wasn't enough for him. Worked his way back inside and made the tackle on the ball carrier.
Two plays in. This is third and two. They'll try to pick up the first with Ekeler. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. Didn't get it by much, but bottom line, got the first down. Avoiding that three and out. How vital is that on the first drive?
To me, it's like the first round of a boxing match. You know, it may not mean much right then and there, but you'd rather not lose it, right? So you want to go ahead and get it. Kind of establish something early and hope it can carry through.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Out of the gun, Herbert finds the open man. It's Mike Williams. There he goes, left side. Touchdown, LA. Mike Williams, 61 yards. And the Chargers have taken a first quarter lead. Well, that's how they envisioned it, get the football to start the game and score it.
And I don't know if that was scripted, was it an audible, or was it just a play call that they had in their pocket. No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
Dustin Hopkins on now to add the extra point. And the Chargers grab the 7-0 lead. Just a four-play drive that time. And it ends with the Chargers getting into the end zone.
the touchdown. Dustin Hopkins will kick it away.
And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. The Bengals offense here ready to rock and roll. Joe Burrow is the man at quarterback.
Hey, we all love a good story, and what we like even more, guys who can fight through adversity. Joe Burrow coming out of high school, goes to Ohio State, doesn't get a chance to start, transfers to LSU, not thought to be a top prospect, ends up the number one pick in the draft, and justifies it. Tremendous play, excellent mobility, and leadership off the charts.
Burrow going to lead up the Bengals here, first and 10
at their own 25-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Chargers able to get the pressure and bring him down. Uchenna and Wosu got the sack there.
And they get to him right out of the gate. And this defense hoping that that's a harbinger of things to come.
Yeah, when you give up a first place sack, makes your quarterback wonder if he's going to go to the sidelines and talk with his offense coordinator and head coach and say, hey, you know that game plan we put together? We might need to change it right now.
Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15. The former second-round pick, this is Joe Mixon. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of five.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
So a third and 10, and defensively, a dime look. Six DBs. They're passing here. Joe Burrow.
That one taken in by T. Higgins.
And they work this well upfield across the 45.
I know at the end of games, coaches always tell us that no one play won or lost a game. But this seems pretty important early, doesn't it? Their ability to pick up that first down on third down, I thought that was key.
Well, you're already in the hole after the touchdown on the other side. How will you respond? We talk about that a lot, and they responded pretty well there. You go three and out, I think you give up a lot of momentum. You get down two scores, could be an entirely different game.
So they've got a nice drive going now. They're in good shape. What's interesting to me is they're also in that spot of the field where you would take a shot. Do you change that up just because you're down a touchdown?
They run on first down as they're able to get this forward for about four.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Here we go. 6 yards left on second down. Going to give this to Mixon, and he'll be close to a first down at the Chargers 44.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
This is third and one, very likely four down territory, even if they don't get it, though. 49. Now it's Burrow. And Burrow going to be hit and taken down. They got him. Credit the sack to Joey Bosa. The start of this game shaping up nicely on that visiting sideline.
Yeah, how about that? You get your points on the opening drive. Then you get a big sack there on third down, and you make the home crowd go, shh.
There is a hush indeed. So on fourth down, on comes the left-footed punter, Kevin Huber, to punt it away. Back deep here, Andre Roberts. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. The Chargers get set to go here for their second drive. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they would. I mean, look, they're on the road. So getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right? Imagine getting up 2 touchdowns on the road, taking the crowd out of the game. It'd be ideal.
Herbert and the Chargers now with a 1st and 10
at their own 27.
They'll run for the first time with Joshua Kelly.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
You know, it's not just all athleticism from defensive linemen. Let's give them a little credit for their football intelligence as well. Read and react by them, understood the play call, and stacked it up and stuffed the run.
Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run.
Herbert will give this one to Eckler.
And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. It'll be a gain of 5, but still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker, and now it's 3rd down.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice gain like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels. And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. Play action. It's Herbert. He dumps it to Eckler underneath. So that'll be no better than an incompletion. And that'll make it 2nd and 10.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch. But even with that completion, 0 yards gained. So they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss. But that window closed quickly. Throwing again on 2nd down. Herbert. Williams brings it in. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35.
Well, it's almost as if they didn't leave the field after their first drive. They picked right up where they left off. Another good throw there. And this offense humming here in the early going.
So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a 1st and 10 at the 34. They'll try the right side with Eckler. And a short gain down to about the 33. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support. And I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
Eckler going to get it again on 2nd down.
And he is going to be close to a 1st down as the tackle made at the Bengals 25. It appears he'll be a few inches short, so 9 yards on the gain officially, and it'll be 3rd down. For it with Kelly, and he will have a 1st down at about the 21-yard line.
Just about every coach we talk to says the crowd shouldn't affect us, that shouldn't be an issue. And then the next breath they talk about taking the crowd and taking them out of the game by picking up 1st downs and keeping them at bay. I think we just saw an example of that there, didn't we?
Important to do, especially early in the game like they have. On 1st and 10, Herbert. And he'll find his man on the out route. That's Allen. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. That was the ninth play of the drive, and they pick up 9 yards with it. Second down, Eckler, and he'll get it here to the 10-yard line.
Well, that was a unit that understood exactly where the first down marker was, handed it to their guy who could run it, created some space, and he got there.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. Going on the ground with Eckler, and he'll get about 4 there as he takes it from the 10 down to the 6.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defense, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Second and 6. Justin Herbert looking to pass. Herbert has it knocked free. And the Bengals grab it. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line. Every week we hear talk about create turnovers. In particular, they wanted to force some fumbles. They got one right there.
And it shows you how the game has changed over time. It used to be good enough for a guy to get a sack of a quarterback in the pocket. Now, if you come to the sidelines and you didn't knock the ball free, your coaches are upset with you, all right? So if you're a quarterback, it starts all the way back in the youth leagues. Take care of the ball, because here come the defenders.
Here we go. Burrow and the Bengals with a first and 10 at their own 23. Burrow going to fake to mix it and now look to throw. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
That's what you're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
Second and 10.
Big 13.
Now Burrow. Got an open man. That's CJ Uzama. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with 3rd and 1.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hands.
They give to Mixon to try to pick it up, and he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first.
So right after the defense gets you the ball on a takeaway and a fumble recovery of their own, you've got to reward them, don't you? You've got to stay out on the field, give them a chance to rest, and how about doing it the way they did it, running the football and picking it up on 3rd down.
Yeah, would not have wanted to go 3 and out. They avoid that right there.
Yeah, they avoided the glares as they went back to the bench, didn't they?
From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Now it's Burrow. And that one is incomplete. And it also concludes quarter number 1. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. A draw play for Mixon. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with third and 9 looming. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
Now the Bengals on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and 9. To Mixon on the check down. And he'll go down to the ground at the 39, and obviously that's well short of the first. 3 yards, all they could muster there, and it'll bring up fourth down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks, don't let them get there, and they rallied and made the tackle.
Here's Kevin Huber now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. 7 yards on the return after a punt of 39. And it'll be Charger football here as they take over. Justin Herbert and the rest of the Charger offense set to take over once more. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of it. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes, but right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number 2 here in the second quarter. Here's Eckler to begin the drive. Now room for Eckler. He finds some open field here. And finally brought down at the 38. 59 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far. One thing that's great about watching him run, Charles, he doesn't hesitate. He got to the left side of his O-line and just went.
So there's 2 ways to look at that. One, just absolutely unconcerned, just takes off and goes. But more the latter, I think, which is he has absolute confidence in the guys in front of him, the guys doing the blocking for him. He just takes it and goes with abandon.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. On the ground, it's Eckler. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Second and 5 now. Herbert. This is caught by Williams. Running on first down, Eckler. Trey Hendrickson, the one who gets him on the ground.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Second down and 8. Here's Herbert. Wide open, it's Allen, complete. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the 1.
One of the selling points of the in route is it gives the quarterback a really nice sight line to his receiver and almost on a direct shot, able to throw the ball into the middle of the field and have a great chance of success as they did on that play.
And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. A one-yard touchdown run from Austin Eckler. And the Chargers find a way to stretch their lead. And he was excellent on that drive. He deserved to be the one to get across the chalk.
Oh, I agree with you totally. A workhorse on the drive. And how about that last decisive run to punch it in?
Hopkins to add the extra point. And it's good to make it 14-0. So that drive, 6 plays, 75 yards. And it's Austin Eckler who finishes things off with a touchdown run. Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. They've had it twice. They've punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice, so they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
Burrow going to lead up the Bengals here, first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. He'll hand it off here. This is Mixon. And they'll wind up getting this to the 37, a gain of 9. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, it makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
Burrow on play action. He'll drop this one down to Mixon. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
Now Burrow on first down. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half, but I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball, and what you have to do, maintain your poise, and start to put together some drives.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. From the gun, a give to Mixon. And he's going to get this inside the 30.
They really needed to get something going, didn't they? They had punted on the last two possessions. The running game starting to come to the front for them, providing a nice pickup there to keep this drive going.
Here we go. Ready? Nice hunt.
Throwing now, Burrow on first down. Over the middle, he finds Higgins. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. Here's Burrow. Boyd's the target, and he hands it over the middle.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
A first chance in the red zone for the Bengals now. First and 10 at the 19. They go back to the ground now with Mixon. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
5 yards remain on second down. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. And he's got it. And he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. Seems as if the passing attack starting to heat up a little bit here in the second quarter.
You can sense and you can see the momentum because now they're reading their patterns downfield, they're understanding the coverages, and they're finding the open holes in the defense.
And he takes it into the end zone. Touchdown, Bengals. Punching it in from a yard away. And the Bengals able to get this back within a touchdown.
Obviously, Brandon, they couldn't get it all back with just one score, but that touchdown chips into the lead, and now it makes the comeback a little bit more manageable.
Evan McPherson now for the PAT. Makes it 14-7. So that drive consumes 9 plays all told. And it ends with a 1-yard touchdown run. To the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. Andre Roberts now to return it. And able to get this out to the 25. The attention shifts back to Justin Herbert and the Chargers offense. He's got to be feeling pretty good. Playing well. Team has the lead, so just looking to mount a drive here that ends in the.
And all quarterbacks will tell you, hey, we love a running game, helps us out. But at the end of the day, they want to rely on their arm, throw the football, feel good about things, keep things moving in the right direction. Right now, that's exactly what we're seeing.
And we'll see if that continues. Herbert going to lead up the Chargers here, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. He'll hand off here to Eckler. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
And that's what I'd like to see out of this defense, a little fire, a little toughness. It hasn't been the best first half for them, but they did do a nice job there, forcing a loss on that play.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Herbert now. That'll be taken in by Anderson. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Chargers on third down, a perfect. terrific 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is 3rd and 4. Here's Herbert. And this is Cook with a grab. And he is going to have the Chargers first down as he'll be marked down a yard or two past the marker following a gain of 6.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. A shotgun snap for Herbert. That's caught right side by Palmer. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. A couple of first downs on the drive already as they'll go from the 47 now on first down. Herbert throwing again. Looking for Allen. He's got him on the slant. And he's going to have a first down on a gain of about 10, and that'll take us to the 2-minute warning. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. And Herbert able to get this one to Eckler out of the backfield. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's 2nd down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
To the air again, Herbert. That'll be complete to Cook.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Here's the 7th play of this drive. This is 3rd and 4. Now it's Herbert. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Cook. The completion there winds up a wash, and it'll bring up 4th down.
Excuse my snarkiness here, but isn't the idea of completing a pass supposed to mean you get downfield and gain yards?
Especially on 3rd down.
Yeah, that one. How about the defense? Figured that one out in a big way. Yeah, they completed it all right and lost yardage.
The Chargers will bring out the field goal unit now. From the left hash, this from 53 yards out. And his kick is good. Oh, he just did tuck it into the bottom of that left corner. And they will move up by 10 now, 17-7. Well, maybe a little bit of an anxious moment there as that ball got closer and closer, but it does curl in.
Yeah, actually did a little bit of a slow dance there with the left upright, didn't it? But had just enough space, as you said, for it to curl in.
Following the made field goal for 3, Hopkins now to kick it off. Taking it about the 1. And he won't quite make it to the 25. Joe Mixon and the rest of his offense making their way back onto the field. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the 2nd quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call it in the West Coast offense, the long handoff?
Yeah.
Serve as your running play that way, as well as continue to feed him the football. These runs now may pop bigger later in the game because of the effects of running it. Sometimes people, after a while, they don't want to tackle him anymore, or they get tired, or they get out of position, or he runs through tackles. Continue to feed him the ball. He's having that kind of game.
Yeah, might they get him the ball in some space in some different ways here. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. First and 10 here, and you know, if they could just get three out of this, something about whittling it to a one-score game at half that might provide a psychological boost. The Burrow's throw here into the hands of Boyd. The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. From the shotgun, it's Burrow. He gets this in the hands of Mixon. And he'll be taken down by the face mask, it appeared. And yes, out come the flags. So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they'll march off another 15 against your squad.
Now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. And that's caught one more time by Boyd. And the Bengals are going to be looking at first and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line. Now the Bengals going to signal for their third and final timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Burrow will throw. That's to Chase. He's got it. Touchdown, Cincinnati. Ja'Marr Chase, as the first half is winding down, and the Bengals are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half.
I think everyone in the league talks about finishing, don't they? Doesn't matter whether it's a quarter, a half, a game, a series, whatever. But they're finishing the first half in fine style, putting that one in the end zone.
They did, and they didn't leave much time on the clock either. Well done. Now, I believe they buzzed down. They're going to take another look at this play with all reviews coming from the replay official here in the final 2 minutes of the half. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How is the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
After reviewing the play,
so they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. McPherson now for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it a 17-14 game. A drive there of just four plays, and it's finished off with a Cincinnati touchdown.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away.
Roberts now on the return. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. The Charger drive about to get going.
And with 10 seconds left, not really enough time to put something together. On the option, here's Eckler.
And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. Tackle made that time by B.J. Hill. So we have reached halftime. Intermission with the visiting Chargers on top. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, right, Brandon. Thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to this slimmed-down version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This one's been as good as advertised. Just a field goal separating these two teams as they've already made their way back out of the locker room. So to bring you the story of the second half, let's get you right back out to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. With work to do in this third quarter, but they'll get the football first as we are back underway. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. The Bengal offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number three. And they're still very much in this game, although they do trail. What's the game plan, Charles, for the second half?
It might be a little counterintuitive because most people will think losing equals passing the ball more, but I'd establish the running game. They kind of went away from it in the first half. I think if they get back in balance, it'll help them when they put the ball back in the air.
We couldn't ask for much more to this point in the second half. A gorgeous day, one score game, first and 10 here.
Mixon will get it to start the second half. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. We'll check on his status when we get back.
Coming up on a second and six.
Again, it's Mixon. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. Call it a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up third and five.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love the blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D linemen to make the play.
An extra defensive back on the field for the Chargers now on third down. Here's Burrow setting up to throw it. That's caught by his tight end, Uzama. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as he's able to get 8 yards there on third and five.
Well, part of their struggles in the first half was their inability to convert consistently on third down. But how about this well-designed play? Gave himself plenty of options and able to get the hookup and keep the drive going.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Burrow looking to pass. Open man is Uzama.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. On second down, here's Mixon. Oh, what a move. And some room to maneuver. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. Joe Mixon, 53 yards. And the Bengals have taken the lead.
Bottom line, when you play a runner with these talents, you've got to be able to wrap up and get him on the ground. Or the first person who gets there, hold him up long enough for the next wave to get there and get him down. Otherwise, he will continue downfield and find pay dirt.
And McPherson on for the extra point. It's up and good to make it 21-17. So that drive spanned five plays, and it all culminated in the touchdown run coming from Joe Mixon. So after the made field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away. Roberts on the return. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. Now a look at the Chargers offense. They get ready for their first possession of the second half. Herbert and the Chargers now with a first and 10 at their own 27. They started on the ground with Eckler. And a tackle there by Jermaine Pratt.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. It's Eckler again. And he'll get about 4 across the 30 to the 32. As they try to defend this on third. Back to throw here, Herbert. Yeah, this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
Here's Ty Long now, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. So possession goes over here on the punt, and the Bengals will take over here first and 10. Cincinnati's offense coming back here onto the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage?
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Derwin James with a pick, and he brings this one back. It's it's a pick six and a Charger TD.
That was a nice catch, and not by the guy you thought it was going to be. How about the defender turning into an offensive player as soon as the ball hits his hands? And off he goes, off to the races, and into the end zone.
Here's Hopkins now for the extra point. And that one gives them a three-point lead. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Taken in at the three. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. Cincinnati set to take over once again. Bengals with a first and 10 at their own 27. Here's Joe Mixon as they start on the ground. And they'll wind up getting this to the 37, gain of 9. Now after that last play, there's a Bengal down on the field. While he gets attended to, we'll step aside. Run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and a yard. Again, it's Mixon. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39.
2nd and 1, if people want to run the football, this is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. This pass complete to Higgins. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them. And these guys have been taking advantage so far.
So from Charger territory now, here's a 1st and 10 at the 43. Burrow going to give this to Mixon. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. 2nd and 10 coming up.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again 2nd and 10. They'll look to throw. There's a short one caught by Uzama.
And let's face it, you can put any Halloween costume on him. You're not going to be able to disguise him because for a tight end of his size, difficult to sneak him anywhere, but that's what they tried to do. Lined up on his right, tried to work his way back to his left, but just a minimal gain as the defense was able to react quickly.
Here we go. The line to gain is the 33 on third down. They're passing here, Joe Burrow. There's a short one caught by Uzama. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. They stop him for only three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
Excellent job there defensively. Gave up the underneath to the tight end on third down, and they made sure that they did their job. Got him on the ground and prevented him picking up a first down.
So the kick from here on a field goal would have been right at 53 yards, but instead, offense out there. They're going for it. And he's got the first as they'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. He's been tough for this defense to handle, over 100 yards. You kind of knew that they were going to him on that play, didn't you?
They certainly did. That's one of those situations where you simply say, my best runner over my best blockers, let's go ahead and pick it up. And I don't care if they know it on the other side. Here we come, and they got it done.
The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Now Joe Mixon. And he'll get this one down to about the 27. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game. And while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
Here's second and nine. Back to throw. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
He did an okay job of absorbing the hit, just couldn't secure the football through the catch.
And he was right there on the spot and forced the incompletion. That's something defenders work on all the time. If you're there, make the contact, but continue to work your way through the receiver so that he can't possess the football and turn it into a catch.
This goes out wide for Mixon. Corral him. He fights through. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7.
And I'll tell you what, this offense is playing a little bit of keep away right now. They've come out here in the third quarter, possessed the ball for quite a while, and they keep on converting. Nice pitch and catch there to set up the first and goal.
Now it's Burrow. Quick hitter here. It's complete. Touchdown, Bengals. C.J. Uzama. A 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Bengals are going to jump back in front.
As a general rule, quarterbacks don't want to lock in on a receiver before the ball is snapped. But in this case, based on the matchup he thought he was going to get, it was favorable for his tight end. He locked in on him early and found him for a touchdown.
McPherson on for the point after. And that will make this a 4-point game. So that one a long 11-play drive. And it ends with a Bengals score.
after the touchdown. McPherson on to kick this one away. On the return, Andre Roberts from his end zone. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result, had he opted for the touchback. And the L.A. offense ready for this next possession.
And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Herbert going to lead up the Chargers here, first and 10
at their own 25-yard line.
Herbert will give this one to Eckler.
And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
Well, in every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
Now a second down and 6.
Out of the gun, Herbert. It's complete to Williams. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They'll fake the handoff. Now Herbert. Has it knocked free, but a Chargers player was able to fall on it, and they'll keep possession.
Fortunate to get that football back, because trailing here in the second half, last thing they needed was to lose the possession.
And the word I think of here is opportunity, because it could have been lost there, their chance to score points, but the opportunity for the defense was to go ahead and really close this game down if they were able to get possession.
The fumble on first down. Now here's second down.
Draw play. It's Eckler. And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of 3. And guess what? It brings up third down.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. On the screen, this is Eckler. And they'll get him down at about the 37, well short of the first. He did his best to just get 4 out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down.
Boy, that was certainly well read defensively. And the key to any screenplay is space to work. And there was none to be found there. And they tackle him for just a short gain.
Here's Ty Long now, as he's on to punt for L.A. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. And a fair catch called for and made just outside the 15-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt. And out will come the offense as they take over.
Joe Burrow and the Bengals set to go back on offense.
He is looking to help his team build their lead after trailing at halftime. They've got to like the spot they're in right now.
They have to love it, but as you and I both know, cliche alert coming here. You're only as good as your last possession. Yeah. But I think that they like, as you said, the spot they're in and how confidently they're playing at this point.
But again, just a one possession lead, looking to expand that now.
Burrow going to lead up the Bengals here, first and 10
at their own 16. Mixon gets the nod to start the drive. They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today.
2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. He'll look to throw. He's got a man. It's his tight end. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Well, from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. Well, let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage. Three-yard gains, that means they're punting the ball likely on fourth down. That's what you're looking for when you're playing defense.
Burrow's throw going to be caught by Boyd.
And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So after two first downs, they get another here. First and 10 at the 45. Out of the shotgun, they run with Mixon. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
135 yards rushing for him now as his sensational afternoon continues. And carries like that, that's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 43. Mixon. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
If you can keep getting gains like that, Charles, with the lead here in the fourth quarter, I mean, keep running it, right?
No doubt about it. But what the offense coordinator has to do is understand they're going to continue to stack the line of scrimmage. What runs do you have in your arsenal that'll work against a stacked box and continue to move the ball?
On second down, Mixon. And a short gain down to about the 33.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
The offense on third down tonight, they've hit 4 of 7. They're looking at third and a few inches. They give to Mixon to try to pick it up. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. Starting to feel a little to me like the air is coming out of the balloon, so to speak, defensively.
They're taking their will from them right now. That's what they're doing. Whatever they want to call, it's working. They're handling things up front. And it's not just the offensive line. It's everyone. You're seeing the guys on the perimeter blocking downfield and making sure that they're secure. So, yeah, you're exactly right. The air is out of the balloon, and right now they're almost lifeless.
So first and 10 now from the 30. It's Mixon on the counter. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29.
Whenever we talk about the best strong safeties, one word constantly comes up, and that's instincts. Being able to diagnose run or pass and make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play.
Still nine remaining on second down.
And now they will throw it with Burrow. He completes it to Boyd. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
One of the things you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
On third down, they've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. This is 3rd and 4.
Now it's Burrow. He'll find his running back, Joe Mixon. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
Now a 1st and 10 at the 11.
Now Burrow. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off inside the 5.
And the Chargers are right back in this football game. A few things better than a big man interception. You can always tell right when they get the football, there's that level of excitement and nervousness and also like, what the heck do I do with this thing?
And you say, no better sight? Well, not for the quarterback who just threw it. It's bad enough to throw a pick, but throw one to the big guy? But you're right about that. Now what do I do with it? But what's fun about it is, you know they're going to be in the film room after this ball game telling all their teammates, maybe I should shift over to offense. I've got skills. What do you think?
Oh, absolutely. I always find myself cheering for them after they intercept it. Unfortunately here, he couldn't make it into the end zone.
After the turnover, here's Herbert. He finds his target, Allen. And he gets this one just shy of the 35 to the 34. Cool under pressure right there, escaping the pocket and finding what I think was not his primary target.
And some of these guys are just so comfortable getting outside of the pocket that they'll do it on purpose. It doesn't even need to be a breakdown. They move, and they know it affects the defense because a lot of times you get lost in coverage in the secondary, and I think you're exactly right. Wasn't his primary target. Found a secondary guy who sprang open, probably because of his movement out of the pocket.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
And partner, they're locked in man coverage out left and they end up running a crossing route. Rounded it a little bit more than a slant. And he's just going to angle himself towards the right side of the field, and that's very difficult for a defender to shadow him across all that ground.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Here's Herbert. He'll get this to Eckler. And he'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. 18 yards on each of the last two plays, and they're picking up big chunks now.
Well, so far, little to no resistance by the defense on this drive alone. 3 passes, 3 completions, 3 first downs. They're taking it to them, and it's paying off.
So 1st and 10 now from the 30. Herbert back to the air.
And that's into the hands of Eckler.
And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line.
That was a beautifully executed screen pass. Let the rushers get upfield. The blocking forms in front. Lofted it to the runner, and now not only does he have open space in front of him, he's got an escort as well, and they pick up big yardage.
only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. Now a clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Trey Waynes.
And the Bengals are going to take possession here at their own six-yard line.
Before we came up to the booth, last thing he said as we were walking off the field, want to play mistake-free football. Well, that just went out the window there with a pick.
And do you remember what you said to me when we were walking up to the booth after he said that? You're like, oh, fatal last words. Every time we hear that, things tend to fall apart a little bit, and that's what we saw there. Didn't get enough on that throw, and it turned into an interception.
To the air here after the INT on the last drive.
Got a man open. It's Chase.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Ahead of the chains now, second and two.
From the gun, a give to Mixon. Boy, shifts past him. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line.
157 yards rushing now for the ball game on 24 carries.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
Got an open man. That's C.J. Uzama.
7 yards to pick up there. Well, that's always a good place to throw it just because he's one of the biggest targets not only on this team but in the National Football League.
And you and I both know the quarterbacks love these large body tight ends, and why not? Nowadays, they're really wide receivers who are just taller and have a little bit more weight. These guys catch the football, make big plays downfield. In the old days, we wanted them to block. Now coaches want them to catch the football first.
And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here.
No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score. And these guys certainly are not hiding what their intention is. They're absolutely showing it. They're definitely not going to sit on this lead here in the fourth quarter.
So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Here's Burrow. Flush to his right. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
On second down now, Mixon, and very little there. He might have gotten a yard. Yeah, I think he got a yard to the 41.
This has been an up and down, back and forth type of a game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive could take a little bit of the wind out of their sails, kind of settle things down a little bit.
This is third and two, maybe the biggest play in this football game. They'll stay on the ground, Mixon again. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. How about this offensive line? They're really starting to establish themselves, take over this game.
And before the series began, I know exactly what was said in the defensive huddle. Guys, we got to get no less than a three and out. Let's get off the field. Instead, they can't find any traction towards doing that. Right now, they're just getting muscled all over the field and getting pushed down it.
line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. They'll set up the screen here to Mixon. And he'll be pulled down as a penalty flag will rain in as well. And that would appear to be a face mask.
Face mask. Defense.
Boy, tight game like this, fourth quarter, personal foul penalties, a no-no.
Yeah, we know the emotions are running high, the tensions are the same. Who can control them best could ultimately win it.
So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense, first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. They stopped after only a yard, taking it down to the 14. Able to stay in bounds, so the clock keeps rolling. This defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in. And all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake it the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover because one more score and this game's over.
So the Bengals in possession of the football here as we get your reset. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. On second down, Mixon. And here he'll get it down to the 7. So fresh out of the 2-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. This is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. Now it's Burrow. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. McPherson's kick is good. And that'll make this a 7-point game. Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
Here's McPherson now to send it away. And Roberts choosing not to bring this one out. Herbert and the Chargers down by 7. 1:47 on the clock. They need a touchdown to the PAT to tie it as they come up first and 10. Throwing, Herbert. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down. A couple extra defensive backs out there in the dime, and because of that, really not many places to throw the football, if any.
And typically, what would you want to do against that dime?
Run the football.
You want to run the ball, but you can't do it in this situation. Not nearly enough time on the clock. You having to really navigate against a tough defense presented against you.
Trying to force it to Allen, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Mike Hilton, and his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. McGregor. Creed, that's twice now in this fourth quarter.
As a quarterback, a lot of times you think it's all on you to make plays when you're losing. And here, the play's not there, but he throws it anyway.
The Bengal offense now gets set to head back out onto the field. And barring mistakes, they should be able to kneel this one out and finish it off. And there's only one timeout remaining on the defensive side of the ball, so that doesn't really come into play either. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Here's a give to Mixon. Chargers going to use their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Once again, they run with Mixon and tackled down after a gain of three. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down. The recipe's pretty simple, I think, right? Just give your superstar the ball, continue to feed him.
Yeah, don't overthink this one, right? Make sure he's touching the football, but you're also counting on his intelligence in playing the game as well. If it's not there, don't force the run. Just make sure you hang on to the football and keep the clock ticking.
Here we go with Burrow. And that will be incomplete. That close on third down, I think everybody probably expecting a run. Instead, they go to the air on third and short yardage.
I realize this is a passing league, and they're liable to throw the ball on any down and distance. But that short, I do question the call. Run the football, pick it up.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a two-score game. McPherson's kick is good. And that will push the lead up to double digits now at 10. So barring something extraordinary here in the closing stages, that field goal should just about put this one on ice.
Yeah, we've got to find two scores. So, you know, we're not going to exactly move it over there yet. It can be done. But, boy, it's going to be a little bit of a stretch for them, isn't it?
Yeah, they would have to move incredibly quick and have some luck, too. Here's McPherson now to send it away. Here's Roberts to bring it out of the end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21. The Chargers getting set to go. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yep, two-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again. But they can't worry about the last 2 points. The only thing that matters is scoring quickly. Then they'll take it from there.
Herbert. That's complete. It's Cook. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
And Brandon, as you know, sometimes it's a lot tougher to run with these tight ends nowadays in the NFL. They're just bigger wide receivers. He lined up on the left side of the formation, ran a drag route across the field, and tried to work his way open. He was able to make the catch, but the defenders were there, couldn't do a whole.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked up by the former first-rounder, Trey Waynes. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. Well, it wasn't always pretty, but the interception there, that means that they should get out of here with a victory.
Yeah, this is not a game that they're going to preserve for posterity on defense, but they did finish it off, didn't they? They did make the winning play to close things out. They'll take that one and head to the locker room.
Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here. And they've got this one in hand. No timeouts remaining defensively, so this one should just be one kneel and then handshakes. here's a first and 10 at the 38. Burrow down to a knee, and that should be the final act of this one.
Listen, anytime you take a knee to end a game, that means you've won it. So it doesn't matter whether it's home or on the road, but there's something a little extra special about doing it in front of your home crowd, isn't there?
And the home crowd applauding. They're happy with what they've seen. Chalk this one up in the left-hand column for a win.
Yeah, that's right. Head to the locker room, throw the wristbands in the crowd for the kids, your gloves, your towels. Get to share it with the home team.
So this one in the win column now for the Cincinnati Bengals. And they were spurred on by a strong performance in that fourth quarter as they held their opponents off the scoreboard.
Everyone wants to pitch a shutout for the entire game, but when you throw one in the fourth quarter, that tells everyone that you're getting stronger and dominance is starting to take over, right? The way that you close, the way that you finish, that gets preached to you from the time you're playing Little League football all the way up through. And they closed them out with a big-time performance down the stretch.
Just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. It's a win for the Bengals as we say so long from Cincinnati.